Bryan, would you do me a favor before we get into this? Would you, let's see, wait a minute, I got a cameraman hiding. No, I have a cameraman hiding on his knees. All right.
He's on his knees.
He's hidden away now. He'd like to make his debut, though. Folks back home, who's over there?
We have John Malcolm Hammond on the keyboards.
Thank you, John, very much. I guess we better go to the drummer in the rear.
Frankie LaRocca.
Hello, Frankie. You know friends of mine, I gather. The Robinsons? Yes, I didn't know that. And my wife just told me. Yeah, he knows everybody,
yeah, he knows
I'm
everybody.
Told. Who's on bass?
Dave Taylor.
Hello, Dave. I'm nice to see you. How about that? Oh, God. I'm losing my mind. Who's over here, please?
Keith Scott on lead guitar.
Thank you, Keith. Nice to have you here, too. I had you working with everybody in the world over there. I was picking out names out of hat. You never worked with Journey?
We're going to, though.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we're going on tour with them for 100 shows.
No, what I had in mind was Foreigner, The Kinks, Loverboy. What happens to you when you walk out in front of an audience that's there really primarily to see somebody else?
Well, it's really a challenge for us, but it gets to be really fun because most of the places we play are really big arenas, and those are always a lot of fun.
I mentioned the fact, let me get this thing out of the way for a second. I mentioned the fact that you go into the studio, and is it true you record like live? I mean, you put it right down?
Well, basically, it's the band in the studio, all the guys, and we go in there and we just put it down and overdub afterwards, but basically, it's the live band.
But normally, what's happened in recent years with all the multiple tracks and all, people go and put a little horn section down, the guitars, the drums.
This is basically the band.
Is this what you hear when we see it in concert?
Yeah, this is what you'll see, the boys.
How long have you been? You see all these guys.
There you are. Everybody.
Good looking group. Where are they all from?
Oh, we're all from Canada, except for Frankie, who's from New York.
New York. No, not New York. New York.
New York.
New York, yeah. How did you fall in with the Canadians? Were you just wandering, tapping on their door?
I knew this bum for a couple of years.
I mean, he's the lead singer. You got to be nice to the lead singer. I mean, gave you a buzz and that's it?
Yeah, I gave him a buzz.
How long have you been working with these crazies?
About a year and a half now. It's a tough job, but someone's got to do it.
I think you have a nice relationship because you can throw the lines back and forth. How many albums have you made?
This is my third album coming up, and it's called Cuts Like a Knife. It's a hell of a record.
Both of these cuts are from it?
Yes, both of them.
Did you write everything in it?
Everything, with a guy called Jim Valance, yeah.
Why is it important to write your own material and perform it?
Well, Dick, something's got to pay the rent, you know?
That's as good an answer.
It's better than working.
No, I was looking for a philosophical answer in something. I got very practical, to pay the light bill.
Before, but yeah, really, it's the truth. It's something I've always done, and I really enjoy it.